Okay, the first question from our audience is, as an elected council member, how would you assure that events like tonight have large attendance of students, especially high schools?
Thank you for the question. So I actually am on high school campus 2 to 3 days a week, coaching wrestling or mentoring kids in public debate. I'm also the advisor of a service club on campus. Our kids feel like they don't have a voice. And although we do have a youth advisory commission, we have recently moved the reporting status of that commission to the Parks and Rec Department, where they used to report directly to the city council. That took away opportunities. We've canceled internship programs at City Hall. Took away opportunities for our kids to get civically involved. And on campus, those student government organizations have very little power to control anything or to make any kind of real decisions. And frankly, a lot of the time, these years are spent fundraising for paper, of all things. We need to engage our youth. We need to bring back programs that our youth were inspired by to be involved, get these activities back into the community, like the Cherry Festival. And I'm telling you, passing Measure L, the Measure L parcel tax, will give the school district more money so that we can go out there and find more opportunities for them and create opportunities for them. Thank you.
All right, so it's pretty plain and simple. I've been coaching youth baseball for about the last 9 years. Coach my son's team over there in the audience. They're about 14 years old now, so they're a 14U team. So if we think that we're going to communicate these type of events but not utilize the new technologies that are out there, such as social media, Facebook, MySpace, all those different things, then it's going to be very hard to get the message out to them, because that's how they're communicating nowadays. So I think we need to do more advertising as far as social media goes and sponsored events on Facebook, and get the message out that these are cool events to go to, that these are events that you want to partake in. I mean, if I was to ask my son, hey, do you want to go play baseball today? He'd be like, oh, yeah. But if I was to say, hey, you want to go to a government debate today to support your dad? He'd be like, all right, Dad. You know, so what it really comes down to is we got to cater to the audience and utilize the technologies that they're using today, and not think that we're going to get by doing it in school and advertising, because that's not going to be the way.
Thank you. I think that we should engage the youth by building strong relationships with the Youth Advisory Commission that we already have. We need to teach them and help them understand the importance of voting and knowing their elected officials. They need to know that their elected officials will listen to their needs and make changes. Also, I see that the time is pretty bad for youth to attend. It probably needs to be on a Saturday, so it won't conflict with their educational commitments.
Actually, 30 years ago when I was in high school, I was involved in events like this. The civics program that we had basically gave us course credit, as well as this was something that I was able to reflect on my resume for college to show that that I participated in civic events. In fact, I participated probably in about 20 civic events as a result of that. Youth is a great channel, but we need to do more. I think we need to do it from the schools, and we also have to engage the students a lot more through those type of programs.